Calvin and Hobbes? The other day in one of the comic strips, Calvin says, "There's no problem so awful that you can't add some guilt to it and make it even worse." Made me laugh and think, this is such a common emotion. This is our true 3 a.m. friend. It keeps us up in the night with regret, remorse, and self-disgust for company. Guilt. I learned long back that guilt is the most useless emotion, yet it keeps many a people caught up in its tentacles. So, that's the focus of this episode, how to get rid of guilt. Hi, I'm Sheila and this is Lumiere 24. Light on! We are all familiar with this emotion, guilt. We do something bad, we feel terrible, and the feeling just won't go away. It eats us away from inside. It makes us feel like a bad person. And though all the personal growth teachers and coaches tell you that you need to let go of guilt, the biggest question is how? Because we have never been taught to deal with it. Growing up is filled with guilt for not being good enough, for dissing our parents, for having survivor's guilt, for having gossiped, smoked, for being abused, whatever. And then as we grow up, we add more. Now we have bad spouse guilt, bad parent guilt, bad kid guilt, bad friend guilt, Catholic guilt and Jewish guilt. And don't forget, no exercise guilt, the overspending guilt, the breaking up the diet guilt. Now, guilt has a few benefits. Research has shown that people who feel guilty are less likely to be psychopaths. Obviously, by the very fact that you feel guilt means you feel empathy. You're being loving, considerate person, right? It makes you a better friend, lover, and employee. I kid you not. But the downsides of guilt are far, far more. While some amount of guilt is actually good to keep our behavior in check, excessive guilt leads to feeling of low self-worth, low self-esteem, and clinical depression. In his book, Feeling Good, The New Mood Therapy, Dr. David Burns, he's a professor of psychiatry at Stanford University, he asks a relevant question. I'm paraphrasing what he said. Every rule break has a limit on punishment, right? So, what would your time limit be for whatever you think you did wrong? And will you stop punishing yourself after that? You see, guilt is often irrational. And if you're the kind who's always feeling guilty and beating yourself up, maybe these few tips may help you. If you feel guilty because you're not doing enough for your kids, your partner, or your family, list all the things that you regularly do for them. Then keep the list in your purse or wallet and pull it out whenever you feel guilty. Guilt and perfectionism both have a negative bias. They make you pay attention to what you're not doing right. So, every day, write down three things that you actually did. This will force you to focus on your achievements. A discussion in the family led to my daughter and niece saying that if only parents clearly explain why they were doing what they were doing, probably kids wouldn't feel so resentful. A point. We often see kids as kids with no understanding or reasoning. Maybe you could ask the people you think you're neglecting whether they actually feel neglected. If you figure out that you really aren't doing enough, then come up with some solutions or compromises that balances everybody's needs. Would you think that your friend or partner wasn't doing enough given all that they had going on? We find it easy to be compassionate and understanding with others, but we are too harsh on ourselves. By deliberately taking a third-person view of the situation, you will get a better perspective. If you are in a relationship with a very needy person or a narcissist, your partner may convince you that you're being selfish by setting limits and saying no. Over time, your guilt and your inner conflict may actually be masking resentment. Accept you're not a bad person, but you did something bad. A lot of people think they'd feel less guilty if they had more self-esteem. Wrong. You don't need more self-esteem. You need more self-compassion. You're human. You'll screw up. Denying that is crazy. Forgiving yourself has all the benefits of self-esteem without making you a narcissist that's out of touch with reality. Unconditional self-acceptance is a great start. And self-compassion, a great chaser. It increases your self-worth. Ask yourself, what can I learn from this? Forgive yourself, repair the damage, and move on. Now at this point, I'm going to hand you over one of my most effective tools from my toolbox, and probably the most difficult. Are you ready? There is one way which is the most effective when you feel guilty. Apologize. That's right. If you think you've hurt someone, just apologize. This is probably the most difficult for you. But remember, apologies make a difference. Believe it or not, research shows people prefer them over money. But here's the tricky part. While apologizing, remember, don't apologize for what you think you did wrong. Apologize for what they think you did wrong. I'm going to let this sink in here. Now, if none of these work, here's the final tip. Get older. That's right. This is the simplest solution. As you grow older, guilt, shame, embarrassment, they are felt less frequently. Notice that old aunt of yours who imperiously demands attention. So if all else fails, just wait. Turns out that the travel agent in charge of your guilt trips will eventually retire. Just kidding. Guilt helps you achieve zilch. Other people are not going to love you more because you have guilt. You're not going to become more productive because you feel guilt. You will not stop adding more things to feel guilty about. You're not a bad person, but you sometimes do bad things. You know what that makes you? Human. If you found this video useful, share it with your friends, family, and co-workers. Guilt helps no one. Let's banish it forever. Spread the light, folks.